You guys ever get high? Who smokes weed? We have medical marijuana in Ohio, maybe, kind of. We don't. Nobody knows how or where to get it or what it means or if the law's real. But it's like the worst medical marijuana law in the country. It's fucking horseshit. But you know what else we have? Weed. Right? Them fucking old squares can have their medical marijuana all they want. It's not like it's hard to get weed. I got weed. Not for you. There's like a few things that I'm super scared of when I'm stoned. A couple of things. One, I don't want to have to make any important decisions. Right? Like I'm really like, whenever I get stoned, I just hope there's not an emergency. And when there is, oh boy, I do not do it right. Ever. My brother and I went to get tacos one afternoon, and I got so fucking stoned. And we went to get tacos. The taco place is like 2 miles from our apartment. That's it, 2 miles. We sit down, we order a bunch of tacos, and my dad calls my phone. And I was so high, I forgot I don't answer the phone. So I answered it. And he goes, are you boys at home? I was like, nah, we're getting tacos. I was real happy about it. It's a good taco place. We're getting tacos. And he goes, you should probably get home soon. There's a big storm coming in about an hour. And I was like, that's a long time from now. Right? I already ordered the tacos. How long is that going to take? We got time to eat the tacos and then go home. It's a whole hour from now. So I hang up and tell my brother, we got to eat these tacos and then go home. Dad said, as if that wasn't what we were going to do. Right? Like I should have just hung up and been like, the plan stands. We should just continue doing exactly this. That's what he called to tell us. But no sooner do I tell him that everything's the same as it was before I answered the phone, my dad calls back. And he goes, I was wrong about it being an hour. You got a couple of minutes. I was like, oh, shit. That is a very different situation. Like, a couple of minutes, number one, is vague. Could be 10, could be 1. We already ordered the tacos, so we're kind of on the hook for that. So now we got to wait for tacos. Boy, those tacos took forever, and I was so high. And I was so excited about the tacos, but then also scared of this fucking monster storm. And then we get the tacos, and we walk out to the car, and it is the most beautiful blue sky you have ever seen. Just, it looked like a fucking postcard. And we were like, this, he's crazy. Does he know where we are or what city we're in? This looks beautiful. And then I turned to tell my brother, he's an idiot. This is the most beautiful. And I realized right here, right above me, directly above me, is just a straight line where everything behind it is pitch black. And everything ahead of it is the most beautiful blue sky. But right here, I'm like in the line. It's like nighttime is coming. It is fucking pitch black. It's like the scariest fucking sky I've ever seen. And so now, this is my nightmare. I am way too high to decide anything. And so we real quick panic, shout at each other, what do we do? Do we go back inside this restaurant? Or do we try to go home? And my brother was like, well, all of this sky is blue. And that is where our apartment is. So if we just drive towards the blue sky, we'll be fine. It's like, that made the most sense of anything I'd ever heard in my life. It's like, fuck yeah, we just stay in the blue. We'll just drive in the blue and get all the way home and it'll be fucking dope as shit. We'll be super fine. What we forgot about was that the sky doesn't have red lights. Right? That shit don't have to wait. There's no yield for the fucking sky. It just keeps coming. And we had a bunch of red lights. And boy, it was like we were collecting them. We hit every fucking red light. And that sky kept getting closer and closer and closer. And then it started creeping up down the windshield. We're at this fucking red light. fucking, we're screaming at each other, but not because we're mad, because we're gonna die. Right? But we're not even like, we're just screaming things like, what do we do? And how do we, what should we do? Like, we just keep variations on a theme. Right? We just keep finding new ways to say, what do we do? How do we not die? What's our next move? It took, honestly, I'm not like thrilled about how long it took for us to realize we could just run the red lights. Like, why the fuck don't we just run the, it's just a light, it's not a wall. Like, just go, what's the worst that could happen? We get a ticket, the cop can also see the sky. There's no cop that's gonna pull us over. If a cop sees us run the red light, he's gonna be like, these guys, they know what's up. I'm gonna give you an escort home because you seem fucking like you got your shit together. But we don't even make it. The sky fucking gets right above us and then it stops moving forward and it starts to spin. The whole thing starts to spin, which is the scariest thing you could see a sky do, is spin. So now we're not even yelling. We're just like, we're gonna die. This is, right? Kind of, if it wasn't natural causes, it was gonna be together. You know what I mean? We can't even make a home. Eventually it overtakes us so, and it's so disastrous that we can't get home. So we stop. And there's that, the IKEA was in between the taco place and our apartment. We used to live in Westchester. And so we stop at IKEA and we're like, let's go inside. That'll be safe. And then we walk into IKEA and realize it's just a bunch of loose fucking wood. Is there a place where we could hide from a tornado and have it be just like hilarious? Like way more hilarious for us to die? Yes, IKEA. So as soon as we get into IKEA, like I swear to God, it was like fucking 2 seconds after we got into IKEA, they made an announcement that said everyone has to, there's like an emergency shelter room in the middle. It's like a hallway in the middle of IKEA with no windows. It's a shelter room. They won't let people leave anymore. Like you, they won't, like if we wanted to leave, they wouldn't let us. Everyone had to go into this little box. And another thing that I'm super terrified of when I'm stoned is being in a crowd. So now all of it's happening. We're jammed up. There's like 150 people in this fucking hallway that holds, I would say, exactly 150 people. We were just walled up, shoulder to shoulder in this room. Terrified. I'm super hungry also at the time. Still very high. Our tacos are in the car. We fucked up. We should have brought them with us. We could have fed the whole thing like Jesus. Right? Like, imagine if we had done that. Right? We have a new parable. These two cool dudes. They had 8 tacos between them. They fed 150 people. At one point, the manager of the IKEA comes in with a megaphone, and he goes, a tornado has touched down 2 miles from here. And then he leaves. That's not enough information to be helpful. Which direction? Is it west of us? Because that means it's coming towards us. Is it east of us? That means we could leave. Do you see why we need more information? Which 2 miles away is it? He doesn't tell us, he leaves. And right in front of us, there's a father and a mother and a kid. The kid's like 8 years old. The parents are probably 5 years younger than me. And the kid says to his dad, he goes, are we gonna be okay? And my ears perk. I'm just like, yeah, what's your answer? Right? You're not my dad, but you're a dad. So I am going to take your response as gospel. Are we gonna be okay, dude? Answer your kid. And the dad was like, yeah, we're gonna be fine. See, picture, he goes, picture a great big cardboard box. And then you just kick around that box and everything in that box gets all smashed up. Right? Now picture a great big cardboard box, but inside that box is a smaller box. Now you kick that big box around, that little box is gonna be okay. And the kid's like, oh yeah, that makes sense. And I'm like, fuck yeah. holy shit, man, that is right. We're in the little box, right? Like, what you're saying is IKEA is the big box. And then the guy's like, why are you... Like, this is my family. And then we left. Eventually. The manager of IKEA comes back in later and says something about the tornado, but he doesn't use his megaphone the second time, so fuck him. And then eventually they come in with the megaphone and they go, the tornado is gone. You guys are free to go. This has been like an hour or 10 minutes. I was very hot. We go back out to the cart. Our best friend was at the taco place with us. He drove separate. We don't know where he is. He did not come to IKEA. We get back to our apartment and he is inside our apartment eating his burrito in the laundry room of our apartment because it's the only interior room of our apartment. So he had dragged a chair into our laundry room and just sat there eating a burrito while maybe a tornado was gonna hit. And he's not scared at all. He doesn't seem frazzled in any way. And we are both, like, my brother is cool as a cucumber all the time, but even he was frazzled. I'm a fucking mess. I'm terrified of tornadoes the most. So I'm losing it. And he's just like, yeah, it wasn't ever a big deal. And then an hour later, he said the funniest thing. He goes, oh, guys, I remember why I wasn't scared. I took a bunch of Xanax before we went to dinner. Like, what the fuck? That should be the commercial for Xanax. All right, thanks a lot, everybody. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful evening.